awesome.
This is so awesome. I've been waiting my whole life for this. I've been waiting to see y'all my whole life.
Absolutely, and it's great to have you here in person. Thank you for being. As a matter of fact, the last time that you were on the show, we were doing the home shows. You were actually there with Songland.
Yes, and we were and we made a song for Game of Games.
Yes, you did.
You know, I'm a songwriter, so to hear your songs getting played and people getting to dance to it and you get to see that joy,
absolutely,
it means something. And she plays it all the time. She always playing our songs, so.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Now, we met on the first time. We met on the pilot of Clash of the Cover Bands, and that was just, that was surreal for me. I mean, like, and now it's finally turned into a show.
It's awesome.
Isn't that crazy?
I think that's what I love about it. It's like, I love the doubt. I'm like, is that gonna happen? Like,
is that
gonna really happen? Yep. And then to see it, and you're like, did that really just happen?
Right.
And then you see the billboards out on the California street.
And you say, is that us?
Oh, my God.
Absolutely.
Look at Esther.
And also, this, I mean, and what's incredible about this, though, Esther, is that, I think our judges panel, and obviously I'm a little biased because I'm on the show, but I think our judges panel is incredible.
Yeah.
Esther, you have written songs for everybody. Call you Esther Dean, the song machine.
Song machine.
She has written for our... Rihanna, she's written for Beyonce, Katy Perry, Chris Brown, the list goes on and on and on. So tell us a little bit about your come up. I know 20 years old, you moved to Atlanta.
Yes.
How was that journey?
Well, you know what? I could always sing, and then I sung my feelings a lot. And when I got to Nebraska, they had like local rappers and they wanted me to sing on their albums. And I said, well, let me ask you something. If I sing on this, can you pay for my studio time and then I can make my own song? Mm-hmm. I was a negotiating child. Mm-hmm. So then they would say, yeah. And I was like, why does this microphone accept me? Right? Mm-hmm. Like if I looked in the mirror, I didn't feel accepted. If I looked in like certain things, I didn't feel accepted. But when I got in front of the microphone, it like loved me.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, I sound good. You know?
Yep.
And I said, I need to do more of this.
Absolutely. Now, have you always written songs? Is that?
Yes. I did it on the Just For Me tape. I'm telling my age, but back in the day, they had Just For Me tapes, and it was the perm tapes, and my mom, she would record Hester, girl, you gotta tell her name, Hester and Esther. But she would record songs from the radio, and I would record myself. And I just wanted to hear myself come out of that thing. Mm-hmm. You know?
It's funny how those gifts are always embedded in us from the jump.
Yeah.
Right? It really is. Yeah. Now listen, we have to talk about Clash.
Come on, Clash.
We got to talk about Clash.
Come on, Clash.
Tell everybody what it's about.
Clash is everything. So Clash is the concert. It's the pre-concert before the concerts, right?
Right.
We want to see J-Lo perform.
Mm-hmm.
We want to see U2 perform. We want to see these people perform right now.
Mm-hmm.
And due to everything, we can't. But God, they done made a way. Jimmy Fallon done made a way for us to get that same experience that we would do if we got to the concerts, and we just get to indulge just right before it opens up.
Absolutely.
Really.
Absolutely. And then, okay, you know, a couple of episodes ago, we got to see a wonderful Tina Turner cover, and I know that was somebody that you would cover, right?
I love Tina, honey.
Mm-hmm.
I know every line. I even know Eat the Cake anime, and, you know, we should know that part, but,
right.
And then, like, I get sound just like, church house, gin house, schoolhouse, out house, the highway of night train. And I get that wrong because it's the highway on 19 where people keep the city clean.
Mm.
That didn't sound like that.
Mm.
Like, I was like, where people keep the kid of king. And I was like, you know, but it's like, you know?
Can y'all feel the passion, right? Right.
Like, that's the first superstar I know.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And Tina was a fighter, man. I want to say this before I get out here and plug this show, Tina was obviously a fighter, persevered and fought her way to the top.
Yeah.
You have also fought your way to the top. What do you have any advice for any young aspiring songwriters coming up right now?
Oh, I think enjoy the fight.
Mm.
Like, turn that fight into championship kind of movement. It's not a fight meaning hurt. It's a fight meaning no. I'm gonna do it, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like, either move out my way or join me on the journey, but we're gonna fight through it.
Absolutely.
Fight through it, not fight anybody, just fight through it.
Absolutely, yeah. Absolutely. That's Esther Dean right there, y'all. Clash of the Cover Bands airs Wednesday at 9:30 on E! Give it up one more time for the incredible Esther Dean.